Thank you, Chairman Alexander, Senator Murray, and distinguished committee members for the opportunity to speak today. Good morning, everyone. As was stated, my name is Ethan Lindenberger, and I'm a senior at Norwalk High School. And my mother is an anti-vax advocate that believes vaccines cause autism, brain damage, and do not benefit the health and safety of society, despite the fact such opinions have been debunked numerous times by the scientific community. I went my entire life without numerous vaccines against diseases such as measles, chickenpox, or even polio. However, in December 2018, I began catching up on my missed immunizations, despite my mother's disapproval, eventually leading to this story and being able to speak here today, and I'm very happy for that, so thank you. Now, to understand why I've come here and what I really want to talk about, I have to share some details about my home life and my upbringing. I grew up understanding my mother's beliefs that vaccines are dangerous, and she would speak openly about these views. Both online and in person, she would voice her concerns, and these beliefs were met with strong criticism. Over the course of my life, seeds of doubts were planted and questions arose because of the backlash my mother would receive. But over time, that really didn't lead anywhere. Now, it's important to understand that as I approached high school and began to critically think for myself, I saw that the information in defense of vaccines outweighed the concerns heavily. I began leading debate clubs in my school and pursuing truth above all else. And I realized one certain quality to debates and to conversations in general when it comes to controversial discussions, which is that there seems to always be two sides to a discussion. There always seems to be a counterclaim or rebuttal and always something to strike back with in terms of debate. Though this may seem true in all instances, this is not true for the vaccine debate, and I approached my mother with this concern that she was incorrect. I approached my mother numerous times trying to explain that vaccines are safe and that my family should be vaccinated. Approaching even with articles from the CDC, explicitly claiming that ideas that vaccines cause autism and extremely dangerous consequences were incorrect. In one such instance where I approached my mother with information from the CDC that claimed vaccines do not cause autism, she responded with, "That's what they want you to think." Skepticism and worry were taking the forefront in terms of information. Now, conversations like these reaffirm that evidence in defense of vaccines was, at least on an anecdotal level, much greater than the deeply rooted misinformation my mother interacted with. And that's what I want to focus on today. To combat preventable disease outbreaks, information is, in my mind, the forefront of this matter. My mother would turn to anti-vaccine groups online and on social media, looking for her evidence and defense rather than health officials and through credible sources. This may seem to be in malice because of the dangers that not vaccinating imposes, but this is not the case. My mother came in the sense of loving her children and being concerned. This misinformation spreads, and that's not necessarily justifiable, but I carry this knowledge with me that it was with respect and love that I disagreed with my mother. And with the information she provided, I continued to try and explain that it was misinformed. Ideas that, again, vaccines cause autism, brain damage, and also that the measles outbreak is of no concern to the society and to America were ideas that were pushed by these sources that she would go to. And for certain individuals and organizations that spread this misinformation, they instill fear into the public for their own gain selfishly and do so knowing that their information is incorrect. For my mother, her love, affection, and care as a parent was used to push an agenda to create a false distress. And these sources which spread misinformation should be the primary concern of the American people. Although change is already placed, more strides can be done. Almost 80% of people, according to the Pew Research Center, turn to the internet for health-related questions. I further explain some more statistics and evidence in my written testimony. Now, in terms of what I would like to walk away with today and kind of finalize with, although my mother would turn to very illegitimate sources and sources that did not have peer-reviewed evidence or information, I quickly saw that the evidence and claims for myself were not accurate. And because of that, and because of my healthcare professionals I was able to speak with and the information provided to me, I was able to make a clear, concise, and scientific decision. Approaching this issue with the concern of education and addressing misinformation properly can cause change, as it did for me. Now, although the debate around vaccines is not necessarily centered on information and concerns for health and safety, this is why education is important, and also misinformation is so dangerous.